Hello everyone and welcome to my channel More to Chess. In this video I am going to analyze only some critical points like some inaccuracy, mistake or blunder. I am trying to initiate more vocal videos, but first I will try with some small stuff and then I will try to bring the whole commentary. Okay, so let's start. Knight a4 is an inaccurate move here. The best move here is d4, because you cannot push the pawn to e4. If you push pawn to e4, then knight g5 attacking this pawn thrice and also the bishop. So after bishop b4, knight takes e4 and white is a pawn up. So the best follow up is bishop b6, d take b4, d takes e4, queen cross d8, bishop cross d8, and then rook d1. And here white is very slightly better because of more developed pieces. Thank you. F4 is not a good move here because F4 allows black to open up the position and also the black pieces to infiltrate into white area. The best move here is to play rook d1 and try to make the position closed. Rook d7 is a mistake because it loses all the advantage for black and gives white an opportunity to equalize the game by the move d4. The best move here is to play rook d4, stopping d4, then knight c2 attacking this rook, then rook d7, again knight e3, and then bishop cross h4. Here you cannot play d4 because after d4, black can play rook g3 check and the position is not same. Black is much better. Rook d2 is a big blunder by white. Here white returns the favor and missed the chance to equalize the game. The best move for white here is to play d4. Black has not many choices here. There are two choices, and in both, rook cross d4 is the best move. If you play c cross d4, then white will play rook c2 with the threat of rook c3, and knight cross f5 is also a threat in future. Here, black has not very much to play. The best move here is rook to c7, rook takes c7, bishop takes c7, and then rook cross d4. After this, rook g1, black try to gain some counter attack, and now rook c4 attacking the bishop. The best move is bishop d8, and now rook c6 check, king d7, rook d6 check, and king c8, and now knight cross f5, and white is much better here. The other move, instead of rook c7, if you takes the knight on e3, then rook c6 check, king e7, rook cross d7. As you can see, if you play this, then I will take this rook. So okay, after king e7, I will play rook cross d7 check, king takes, and now rook takes. So this is also completely winning. And also here you cannot play bishop cross h4 because of the move rook c6 check, king f7, and then knight cross f5. This is also a big advantage for white, as you can see 5 points, because white is attacking all the weaknesses in the black side. Okay, so here the only move is rook cross d4, which equalizes the game for black. After rook cross d4, takes d4 and then knight c2 attacking the pawn and then also attacking the f5 pawn. So black have to play king d5, and now the best move is knight cross d4 with the idea of this. So king takes, rook check, king c5, and then rook takes bishop. So this is completely equal position.